I'm Radhika, Radhika Timbaria. I started Champaka Bookstore in June last year. We wanted a name that was very local to Bangalore. It could be a bookshop or it could be some fancy name, but then it would be located, could be located anywhere in the world. We wanted to place ourselves in Bangalore. So Champaka is the name of is the scientific spelling for the name Magnolia Champaka, which is our beloved champa tree in Bangalore. We wanted a space that we felt comfortable in, that we felt natural, that we could. I didn't want air conditioning, and I didn't want glass windows, and I didn't want people to feel disconnected. Like, you're in the center of the city, but you don't hear the traffic here. Even though, you know, we have an avocado tree that people come, and when it's full of avocados, we pluck those avocados and put it on a sandwich and serve it to people. So we wanted to maintain all of those connections. I feel like if books really open doorways into different worlds for you, but also really help you understand where you are in this world. So we've gathered a collection which is diverse in that way, that we talk about caste, and we talk about queer lives, and we talk about feminism and things that people might shy away from. And even when there are as many women authors, sometimes they don't get the kind of credit that the male authors get. So I think we bring in a sensitivity to bring in that sensitivity to our store. So we always have more than 40% women authors. Most people actually come, take the time, sit with their books, and maybe when they sit quietly for 20 minutes, half an hour, they might like the book better. They might take the time to get to know that book, or they might not buy it and buy another book that they do like. And I think that's the point of this. It'd be nice, like, get to know your books, feel the pages, read a few paragraphs, see if you like it, you know. We spend a lot of time in curating our books. We also spend a lot of time in getting to know the people who we're recommending to the books to. So we hope we're recommending the right books to the people. People are absolutely allowed to drop by and pick up a book they like. If they don't feel comfortable, feel free to call us and tell us, I like these kind of books, and I'll take you through our shelves and, you know, help you choose the book that you want. We also post books all over India now. And we've launched a subscription program that this year focuses on translations. So we hand curate each title and write a curation note about why we've chosen that title. And every month we even discuss that book with the author. So we're trying to do a lot that people can do from the safety of their homes, but also if they want to come in from next month, they can. And we launched a website in May this year, something we never thought we would do, but it's just something we've had to do. So people can also check that out. We've only open a year and something, and then the pandemic hit us, we were 10 months old, so we were very, like, I didn't know what to expect, whether we would survive this also or not. But we have a very good, loyal customer base that we've built in such a short period of time, who really came out and supported us. So they do like this experience of seeing and discovering books. They like this experience that we create for them, where they get to speak to the authors that they're reading also. So I think while it is true that bookstores are suffering, but I feel like people also want this experience. In this time when everybody's connections are breaking with reality, they want this connection, and I take hope in that.